Next, I invite Professor K. Devananda Acharya Swami, who is the Dean of Darshanas and Head of Vishishta Dvaita in the Rashtriya Sanskrita Vidyapeetha in Tirupati, and he is a former Pro Vice Chancellor of the Venkateshwara Vedic University.
Pranamam Lakshmana Munihi Pratigrinhatu Mamakam Prasadhayati Yatsuktihi Swadhina Patikam Shrutim Upavitinam Urdhapundravantam Trijagat Punya Phalam Tridandahastam Sharanagata Sarthava Hamide Shikhaya Shekharinam Patim Yatinam. I pay my Sashtanga Pranamas, Ananta Pranamas to Bhagavad Ramanuja. I pay my deepest regards to Tridandi Sri Chinnajiyar Swamiji, other Swamijis also. I feel very fortunate to be here in the midst of great scholars like Professor Lakshmitatha Acharya, our KVRK Acharya Lugaru and others. This is a great opportunity to me to express my opinion on Ramanuja's philosophy. The Ramanuja's philosophy, though it was propounded by great Acharya Nammalvar or Bhagavan Sriman Narayana himself, as we say, but Ramanuja established its tenability among the masses. As explained by Sriman Varkhedi, Aikakantya, that's a great concept Ramanuja adopted. Not a single scripture of Upanishad. Went unexplained. He explained all Upanishadic scriptures with logical arguments. Nyaya Yuktartha Varnanam. Yas Tarkena Anusandhate Sadharmam Veda Netaraha. This is a great thing we come across in Ramanuja's text philosophy. One more thing I have come across, and many others did say about Ramanuja's text. There are many successors available to Ramanuja, like Vedanta Deshika, Tattvasara Granthakarta, Acharya, Varadacharya, Nadadu Rammal, and others. All Acharyas explain Ramanuja's position in different way, but the thing is, the concept is same. The huge books are coming out. After going through these books, if you go back to Ramanuja's Bhashya, you will find everything in Ramanuja Bhashya itself. So, the books are made in huge volumes. Many books are coming out, but nothing is new, because Ramanuja has explained everything in Ramanuja Bhashya, Sri Bhashya. That is the greatness of Ramanuja Bhashya. You take the case of Shruta Prakashika. One more thing, our Acharyas, we have to say these things to our youngsters, our youth. Shraddha Viplava Vipralambha Padavi Vaideshikaha Deshikaha. Our Acharyas never hide behind any kind of this, compromise or something. So we can compromise with this one. This argument cannot be, this argument cannot be answered. These are unanswerable questions. These kind of questions cannot be posed to Vishishtadvaita. This kind of nature never I have seen in our text. They are very assertive in describing the Vishishtadvaita philosophy. One more thing, this Siddhanta is based on a concrete pillar. Bhagavad Bodhayana Kritam Purva Vistirnam Brahmasutra Vrittim Purvacharya Sanchikshipuhu Tanmatanusarena Sutraksharani Vyakhyasyante. Here Shruta Prakashika says, Atra Rishehe Abhiprayaha, Atra Rishehe Anusaraha Pratijnataha. He in the first statement itself, Ramanuja says, we are following Bodhayana, etc., while commenting the great Vyasa. So there is no scope for any kind of error in the commentary. That should be our thinking. We should approach Ramanuja's Bhashya that this is the commentary based on Purvacharya Maharshi. This is Maharshi Siddhanta. This kind of, that's why each and probably in many adhikaranas he says taduktam vritti krita. So Aikyashastriya, take the case of Aikyashastriya, we are not, Bhashyakara, our Ramanuja does not hold this Aikyashastriya only to hold this Aikyashastriya. He hold this position because Vrittikara says, Bodhayana says, Samhita Meda Chari Rakam Jaiminiyena Shodasha Lakshana Neti Shastri Gatva Siddhi. So with this perception we have to approach our Ramanuja's Bhashya. One more thing, this Ramanuja Bhashya did not reach many corners of the world. This is a thing of distress. Advaita reached everywhere. Ramanuja's philosophy did not reach the world. The people who are working on philosophy, I am very sorry to say, people who are working in the department of philosophy in the foreign countries, they are also working on Advaita philosophy only. Some years back I have met one person who belongs to the tradition of Sri Vaishnava, great tradition he belongs to, but he was talking the concept of Tattvamasi in the direction of Shankara's philosophy, Shankara's doctrines, utterances. It is not a problem, but he has to spell something on Ramanuja's text also. I asked him, you are belong to this tradition, why didn't you speak about Ramanuja's position here? This happened in Madras University. He told me, sir, I am professor of philosophy in so-and-so university. I should not say that. But I have never come across the explanation of Tattvamasi given by Ramanuja. This is a sorry state of affairs prevailing in the world. We have to do. This is not, we are sorry. We should be sorry. We all should be sorry. We have to work for that. If the philosophy spreads, then only the sampradaya will stand intact. If the philosophy is not kept alive, then we cannot save our sampradaya, because sampradaya is based on our philosophy only. Nowadays people, some people say, Ramanuja did not deal with philosophy, he is a sampradayika. He is a religious person. Yes, Ramanuja has come down. Ramanuja has come down to ground level. He is a great social reformer, no doubt. Being a social reformer, he can be the most celebrated philosopher also. The two things cannot remain in Ramanuja, people say. If he is a social reformer, he is not a philosopher. Some people think like that. So the philosophy is the foundation. One more thing I want to express here. So you see, we have to study our Sri Bhashya. Every house should have at least Sri Bhashya Pustaka. Our Rangaramanujacharya Swami is working vigorously in this direction. He is not doing the project. He is the project. And he is doing, always thinking about projects. He is bringing out good things, good books. But thing is, mere taking the Sri Bhashya in our house, bringing the Sri Bhashya and putting in inside the house, will not help us. At least we have to see, at least we have to understand what is the purport of Ramanuja Sri Bhashya. What is going to say? What is the doctrine of Ramanuja? What is the philosophy of Ramanuja? Why our preceptors worked a lot in this direction? We have to work there. If we do, Atmaiva Hyatmana Bandhu, Atmaiva Ripuratmana, we have to think about our Atma only. I am the different person, we should not think about the society. If all of us think about our own Atma, Atma Kshema, then the society is very much happy, distressless. I am putting one instance there. Now, cricket is all pervasive. Everyone knows cricket. Everyone follows cricket. Is there any celebration of any cricket, about any cricketer? People celebrate cricket in their house, but every mind is pervaded by cricket. Every mind is pervaded, like politics. Okay. Every mind is pervaded by cricket. Our religion, our philosophy, Ramanuja should be having a simhasana in every mind, every hridaya. That should be our goal. That should be, without that, great thing we are doing, without that, nothing will be achieved. Mind should be directed to Ramanuja. Always we have to think about Ramanuja. Ramanuja should have the supreme place in our mind. At this juncture, I want to say about this millennium statue of Bhagavad Ramanuja. It will be another Taj Mahal. People will throng here, they will come. But in lighter when you take, and it is not another Taj Mahal. The tourist will visit in lakhs and in great number. That is my opinion. It is not a Taj Mahal. It will be known. Its reputation, the familiarity will be like that. More than Taj Mahal. People will notice this great thing. Our Swamiji has done one thing. He has brought Srirangam here. Srirangam has crossed Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. He entered in Telangana also. Srirangam is now available here. Bhutapuri is available in our Andhra Pradesh. That place. Narsapuram. Bhutapuri has come, but Srirangam did not come. Srirangam now has come here. A great thing, great achievement. It's Atimanusha Karyam, Idam Vartate. Yedadartham Yete Atyantam Sarvirapi Shlaghaniyaha Asmakam Sri Charanaha. Yetadasha Karyam Teva Kartum Shakurvanti. Shubhena Manasadhyatam Ityuchyate. He thinks about big things. He achieves big things. He files never. His agility is unmatched. He is still young. Yatahi Prataha Uktam, young Ityuktam, Anyesham Vishaye, Maya Uchyate, Yantusesam, Agility. Even jargon, Vartadekal Angla Bhasha, and Sarvam Atra Yojjata, Agile, Enthusiast, and Able, Yetadishaha, Yete, Shicharana, Santi. He. 120 years, yes. 120, now he has crossed only 60. And, he will have another 260s. Nowadays, in cricket language, I should not encroach here, but one thing, everyone knows cricket. 20 years back, making a century in one day match was very rare. Now, 200s are made easily. 200s are made, what my understanding is like that. Like that, he has got lofty goals. In our view, these are very lofty. But in his view, these are easily achievable because of Ramanuja's kataksha. Ramanuja is there. He will fulfill everything. At last, I thank the organizers, especially our Rangaramanuja Charalu. He has a very soft corner towards me. He has got a very soft corner. That's why I am standing here. And my prarthana with the masses, last time also I told this, everyone has to have some access to Sri Bhashya. Everyone has to read Sri Bhashya. Sri Bhashya should be all pervasive. It should be all pervasive like Bhagavan. Bhashya. Bhashyam, prabhadye pranavakaram bhashyam. Prapadye pranavakaram bhashyam rangamivaparam. Parasya brahmano yatra sheshitvam sphutam ishyate. We have to pray only bhashya, not Ranganatha, not Teva Pramad. Only bhashya. Bhashya will take care of everything. My simple request is you have to be very much careful about our dialectics. The Bhashyakara entered in dialectics. The method of dialectics should be encouraged, and many people should come out with these words. I don't want to bore you more. Mama pranamaha, mama dhanyavadaha.